Now you know why he wears the helmet. From Young and Elm, this is City TV everywhere. Welcome to CITYTV's Speaker's Corner, the television show by the people for the people. Now, to find out what's been on Toronto's mind lately, let's go to the video booth for a few highlights from this week's show.
They should do something about teaching people how to drive a little more properly. I'd like to talk today about noxious weeds.
I'm upset about the Two Live Crew.
This is for my husband, Kevin. He's the best thing that ever happened to me, and every day is special with him. That's about all.
Your eyes are like diamonds that twinkle on a moonlit night. Your heart is one of gold, more pure than the purest mine. Your love is a treasure, not one to be buried. I love you beyond measure, even more when we get married. I love you, Pat.
Hi, Brian. you're right beside me, but I love you anyway.
Are you single? If you are, leave your women. Come join us.
Ditto.
Ditto.
Lucas?
Thank you, okay. Full name?
Hi, Ziggy. I have 13 seconds left. All I want to say is, hi, Lisa. That's my girlfriend. I love you.
I think, basically, I would just like to say thanks to the women of Toronto, because you have been great! Yeah!
1, 2, and threesomes. They were the best.
They were best. In fact, I think the best was the big old twosome.
Let us build a bomb.
Hi, I'm Pierre. I'm come from Belgium, and I'm very happy to be in Toronto. It's a very interesting city, and I like the way all the buildings are built and Canadian architecture. And I can compare it with different other cities, and this is a real nice city to be in. It's a very big city, and I was pleased to have a very good guide to show me the most beautiful things here in town. And really, I can appreciate the way Canadian people are very clean in such a big city. It's beautiful.
I'd like to say a few words about no-fault insurance. I was badly injured about 2.5 years ago, and I'm still hurting like heck. On the 401, I was hit 70 miles an hour. I feel real, real sorry for anybody who's injured under no-fault. The worse you're injured, the less you're going to get back in compensation. You get nothing for your pain and suffering. I'm going to hurt for the rest of my life, and many others are in the same position. I just can't believe that the Ontario government has actually sold all of the people who are injured in car accidents to the insurance companies. It's not for nothing that the only people who were happy about no-fault insurance were the insurance companies. They're the only ones who win. All of the injured lose.
English is not the only culture in our country. We are a multicultural society. We should be embracing our immigrants. They're helping our economy. English is not our only culture. We are enriched by other cultures. We should be embracing them.
I work for CITYTV, and I have to come out and empty this box sometimes, and it really makes me sad when I come out and see that somebody has broken into it. Half the money, you know, that we get is being spent on repairing it when it's supposed to be going to the Chum City Christmas Fund. And it really, really saddens me, the fact that it's put here for the benefit of children and people have to steal from it.
Whatever you think's going on in the world right now, boil it down to this question. Are our schools teaching kids the three R's? And I do mean effectively. not are we better than Idaho or are we better than some other state or province, but are we teaching kids the three R's in a really top-notch way? This is an age of information, and obviously the equipment we need to give kids is the three R's so they can take that information and be critical and make good decisions for a good world.
I moved to Toronto today, and I'm from Montreal, and, well, it's not as bad as I heard.
It's not bad. It's not a bad place. It's not terrible, like we heard. But every day we walk down the street and we look around and we see something that's not so terrible, but the same thought goes in our head. It is not Montreal.
Hi, I'd like to say something about police cracking down on speeders. I can't say that I've never speeded before, but if they really want to do something or crack down on the accidents that are happening in this city or around in Ontario, they should do something about teaching people how to drive a little more properly. For instance, every 5 years that you get your license renewed or whatever, you take a driver's test. Otherwise, nothing's really going to change from the speeders. People who speed are not going to really change their minds just because the points go up or the fines go up.
Gorchak, doing a good job. Don't let those guys hassle you, eh? Just free Lithuanian.
I'd like to talk today about noxious weeds in Ontario. There's very many noxious weeds taking over. Purple Striker and Goldbeard are some of the better ones. They're taking over our marshes. We've got to do something about it. Noxious weeds grow in people's gardens. Very bad, very bad.
CITYTV is doing a great job downtown here. They're really speaking out for Toronto. They're doing a great job for us. I think when people think of Toronto, they associate CITYTV with Toronto. Congratulations, guys. You're doing a great job. Thanks.
I just think that once again, the human race stands on the brink of war. We stand looking at the possibilities of strife and heartache all across this planet. And I'm just wondering if we will ever look at women, children, our children's children, and the whole miracle of Mother Nature as a reverence. If we will ever look at that and start to appreciate the fact that this is one planet, we have nowhere to go, and we need to really get together and think about the possibility of what this planet could be. That's all I have to say, really. I hope and I pray that somehow we'll pull it all together and this planet will be one race of people, namely the human race.
I think interactive television is a really great thing, but I'm just wondering, like, why do you have to charge for it? I mean, what's the idea? Is it that a dollar keeps the riffraff off the street? I'm not sure what the plan is. I decided to ask you that. Maybe you can cut me in and then answer it after it.
Yes, I can cut you in. I will cut you in. I have cut you in, and I will answer your question. My name's Peter Whittington. I'm the producer-director of Speaker's Corner. And to answer your question, there are two answers, really. First of all, the most obvious one is that all the money, the dollars that you put in at Speaker's Corner, go to a very good cause, the Chum Charitable Foundation. We buy Christmas presents for kids, for needy kids at Christmas time, things like that. It's a very good cause. Secondly, we feel that if people put a dollar into the machine before they start speaking, maybe they'll consider their comments a little more carefully before they actually make them. That way, we get more quality stuff. We're certainly not against silly comments. We have a Joker's Corner, and we like to, you know, foster some funny things. But at the same time, we like people to consider their contributions before they give them. We feel that charging a dollar will make people pause for a second before they put the money in and think about what they're going to say. Answer your question?
Elvis Presley lives, and I think he should govern our country. And in fact, I think Erica M. was married to him.
You know, did you ever think about how the world and society is a cabbage, and all the layers of the cabbage are like layers of the world, and you could peel them apart and kind of see and look at each and every one of these different layers of the world like a cabbage? It's actually a frightening thought when you think about it. I think about this often. These are the kind of thoughts that plague me when I lay in bed and try to sleep. Of course, I never sleep. weeks go by, years. I find it very lonely, actually.
There are very many good sights to see in Toronto.
Hi, this is Samantha and Heather, and we're like really upset that school's summer's come to an end, and this is our little tribute to the end of summer. Go on, Heather.
Okay, let's sing with you, baby.
1, 2, 3. Nothing compares. Nothing compares to summer.
I am a tourist.
Hi, Daddy.
You ever been fishing in the St. Lawrence?
No.
What are we gonna do now? Answer my question.
What?
You know what the limit is?
No.
6.
Oh.
4 Hells Angels, Crooked Cop, and a bad judge.
You mean to say you haven't any money left from your allowance?
I didn't mean to tell you, but you found out anyway.
They say, never judge someone till you've walked a mile in his shoes. So I walked a mile of my own and came here.
A new man.
I live better. Even eat better. And when I eat margarine, it's Fleischmann's.
Fleischmann's Corn Oil Margarine. Make it part of your life.
When I think of how I used to be, I wouldn't want to be in that man's shoes.
Holiday wishes can come true. But do they want them to?
One kiss, and I can't sleep or eat.
But I've never done this kind of thing before.
It scares me a little, too.
There's only one way to cancel wishes.
It's going to be a miracle.
But will it work?
Sometimes happy endings are a lot better than you imagine, huh?
Lonnie Anderson stars in the city premiere Coins in the Fountain. 9 tonight.
I got 3 days.
You got all the time in the world.
Saturday, Tommy Lee Jones races against time to recover a secret.
He got in exactly 72 hours to lay that cassette in my hand. I need that funny-looking car.
Just how badly do you want that car?
They're trapped.
Get me out of here.
Black Moon Rising, a CITYTV premiere Saturday at 10:30.
If you're watching Much Music right now, I just wanted to let you know that every day of my life is filled with visions of you.
It's making me sick.
Shut up. You're wonderful. You are an artist. You are just the sexiest musician there could ever be.
And whoever remotely looks like him, she falls in love with.
Yes, on the spot, but you are number one. You are the original Pete Townsend.
He's married and his wife is having a baby.
She had a baby. Baby boy. Congratulations.
Y'all keep doing these late, great CITYTV commercials, you know, and the people keep screwing up. So we want to check this one like this. Check it out. Yeah, you're listening to the brothers from VIP. So you're seeing it live on CITYTV. You want to get down and go like this? Check it out. A couple words from a man, kid.
Double or nothing style, and I'll be singing it to you clever. Oh. We're gonna drop the sway to heat the set up like a sweater.
Yeah.
So stay tuned to CITYTV and check out the late, great movie.
Back to reality, back to life, back to reality. However you want me, however you need me, however you want me, however you need me, however you want me, however you need me.
Who's your favorite guy, Heather?
Slash from what group?
Guns N' Roses.
That's good.
And you, Sharon?
Some guy named Dave Ellison.
Wait, who's that?
Want to see you?
Meg, up there. Megadeth. Yeah.
Right there.
We want to meet Paul Abdul, all three of us.
Okay.
We still have more.
Yeah, we got one more minute. Okay. Jenny Chuseida. Shena Mitreba. Koya ima plavu sharu. A ja imam strašnu karu u tem Torontu.
Do you like watch music? I do. I watch it almost every day and I think it's great.
I've got something I'm really, really upset about. I'm upset about the Two Live crew. As nasty as you want to be, being banned from record stores. It's not that it's got explicit lyrics. Fine. Put a label on it, make it 16 and over, 18 and over, 19 and over, I don't care. I'm 24 years old. I want to own an album. And I can't. Why can't I? Because you guys say that it's too nasty. It's too obscene to be seen or heard by Canadian viewers. I'm sorry. You're wrong.
I'm Sam the Record Man, and to answer the young man's request for the Two Live Crew recording, that recording had been available in all our stores across Canada up until the time that Warner Brothers Canada pressed a version here and put it out in the market. And it's always been a policy of ours not to carry what you can call a parallel import when one is available here in Canada. There's obvious reasons for that. The recording released here in Canada is half the price of an import. It's a performance that's guaranteed by the distributor here, and we particularly don't like antagonizing the Canadian manufacturer when they have a release out by what we call bringing in a parallel import.
Getting back to reality, Mulroney, you're gonna wreck our country. You're gonna wreck it. I may be an immigrant, but I add to this multiculturalism because one day I'm going to be someone in Canada.
Erica, you are real.
I'm sorry. But Mulroney, get a life, man. Stop fooling us. You know, we're paying for your limousines, for your fancy dinners, everything. We're our social programs.
The subject is Bob.
Bob Ray.
Bob Ray.
Okay. You're our new friend. Well, so, he might be for a while.
Right now, all these people here are all liberal and conservative people.
I'm blue.
Blue and okay.
Well, who's liberal? Someone's liberal.
I'm upset.
Liberal.
Upset as upset
so everyone's
can be.
Upset, but they shouldn't be.
Oh, wait, Bob, you're in now, so.
Well, Bob, I'm a little bit concerned. I hope you can help us out.
Bob, I think you should lower our taxes and increase
yeah,
wages.
Bob, help. First
Bob, you better pull your weight, man.
But Bob, it's $900 million deficit. Please don't.
Yeah, Bob, no more deficit,
don't,
but
Bob.
I want to buy a new house.
Maybe you can increase spending somehow without
what
raising taxes
and
not increase the deficit.
No, no.
You know, I think it's ridiculous that now that we're nearing the turn of the century, we still use a lot of old euthanisms to demoralize people, like women still being called girls. I mean, we're all supposed to be equal, male, female, black, white, and it's a bit ridiculous to call a grown adult, grown woman a girl. It's not only sexist, you know, but it's demeaning, and I think there should be some kind of a law that any woman over, you know, any female person over the age of 18 that should be illegal to refer to them as a girl.
We came down here today to Skydome. Mind you, because of the box tickets, me and my friend, and we took the school. And my mom told the school, yes, that's my mom, and she said that we had Lucas fever. You feeling okay? Okay. Anyways, and this is my friend Shannon, and we both love Jordan.
And Joe.
And Joe, of course, Joe. Little Joe.
Yeah, I just want to say that the power hour is too short. You guys don't play enough heavy metal. And, you shouldn't play so much New Kids on the Block because they're really bad.
My name is Anne.
I just want to say, with all the bad things happening in Toronto, we should be grateful that we live in such a wonderful city. I mean, it's clean, it's pretty much safe, and everybody kind of gets along. There's a lot of bad guys, there's more good guys than there. I think you should be glad you live in Toronto. I wouldn't want to live anywhere else.
I see a lot more men walking around, not being ashamed of carrying a stroller around or a carriage, and they have so much love in their faces, and they're not ashamed of it, and I think it's great. I think it's great that they also help their wives out, because they used to grudge the burden of looking after the children themselves, and they used to be the only disciplinary, and now there's two. And I just think it's a really, really great city that we live in, and I think people should be more appreciative of what we have, because if we didn't have what we have, then we'd have nothing.
As for the subway, who cares if you wait 10 minutes for the subway? Big deal. At least you don't have to worry about paying $18 for a half an hour for parking.
Flying baby.
Canadians can't drink beer at all, and
what are you going to do if you want to be a Chelsea football fan? You've got to make sure that you wear the very, very thickest football boots that you can possibly find, and you have to be able to practice this initiation ritual going, I am a Chelsea football fan, but you don't say it like that. What you've got to do is go,
I don't think enough people in Toronto have beers. Not very many. Now, I would like to see a beard in every pot. That's my campaign slogan. Vote for me.
I don't like
I had a strange dream about flying the other night.
About flying the other night.
I hope no one's watching this on the other side.
You've got 35, 34 seconds, 33. Mom, hello.
Say hi to your mom.
I grew up.
Here I am, grown.
Look what you produced.
I don't want to reproduce anymore. You wonder why? Are we over yet?
Goodbye. Signing off. This is Gordon Martineau, City Pulse. Good night.
Well, you said test an experiment. Test an experiment.
Expert limbs and organs taken from people.
I've got to have them to work with. Sure, I've made a few mistakes, but I've learned from them. I've learned.
If we put any more fruit in double fruit, we'd need a bigger jar.
You know, at Leon's, you now get a discount off your furniture when you pick it up yourself. And now during 0 days at Leon's, we're offering zero money down, zero interest, and zero payment till next year. Plus zero minimum purchase and pickup discounts. 0 days. Just another reason to shop at Leon's.
Sunday at 8. This cop's in the doghouse.
Monroe, don't screw this one up.
But science just gave him a canine cohort.
For a second there, I thought you were talking.
You're hearing me through a microchip receiver. You're the only one who can hear me.
You're amazing.
No, just cellular.
What do you mean you couldn't find him?
It's the world television premiere of K-9000, 8 p.m. Sunday.
You don't understand any of this, do you?
Am I in danger?
Monday, drugs and deception put an innocent woman's life on the line.
Someone's downstairs.
Madeline, are you there?
Lonnie Anderson stars in the city premiere Sorry, Wrong Number, Monday at 8. And now, this week's winning Speaker's Corner contribution.
The sun had not yet reached the warm horizon. Everything was working as was planned. Till the butcher's sharpened knives were the invasion, and the blood would flow like rivers through the sand. The soldiers in a town, they raped and looted. No concern was given to the fact of clues. Taking orders from a mad psychotic monster who never met a weapon that he wouldn't use. He never met a weapon that he wouldn't use. Well, sad damn. Tried to defend the royal palace, with blood and honor spilled into the streets. The town, he said, he turned into a graveyard. Yeah. If foreign powers made attempts to intervene, sand blew across and captured death and kingdom. The mood had turned from frantic to a calm. The people moved in darkness to the border to escape the butcher king of Babylon. To escape the butcher king of Babylon. Service announcement brought to you by Pieces of Train.
Well, that's all this week for Speaker's Corner. Remember, we're open 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. So stop by CITYTV, 299 Queen Street West, and have your say. Just drop in a buck, state your name, address, and phone number, and let her rip. Once again, all proceeds go to charity. So come on, Toronto. We want to see your face and hear your voice on Speaker's Corner. 30 minutes from now, Lonnie Anderson gets romantic in the love capital of the world, Rome, coins in the fountain, a CITYTV premiere 9 tonight. Tinseltown Time is next with MT Movie Television.